My name is Jude Anthony Angelini. This is the All Out Show. Sierra's not here, so that's why we're listening to the Beatles. That and because they're fucking awesome. And it's White People Wednesday. And that's what happens on White People Wednesday. I listen to the fucking Beatles and shit. I'm wearing boat shoes without socks right now. Right now without socks. We got a good show for you today. We got this lady coming on from Carrot Dating. Now, Carrot Dating is this app where you can trade goods and services for a shot to date a chick. I.e., like, I don't know, a juicer or a necklace, and then the girl will go on a date for you with you. This is for whores and dudes that don't have game to pull a chick. And there's enough of them out there for this to be a viable fucking app. Every now and again I say words where I'm like, I think that works, but I don't know. Viable. Capable of working successfully. Feasible. Fuck yeah, I said it right. God. Every now and again I'm just like, I wish I would have paid attention in English class. Seems high. I do have a job on the radio and I gotta do word talking. Anyway, so we got the Carrot Dating lady coming by.
Actually a guy.
Oh, it's a guy?
Mm-hmm.
Carrot Dating guy. I thought it was like the, I thought it was like their, hold up. That was a chick. I thought it was a, I thought they had a woman as their PR person. No?
No, it's okay. A guy. It's the public relations right. Manager.
The PR manager?
Mm-hmm.
What's his name?
Leroy Velasquez.
PR Leroy. He's got the black first name, the fucking Mexican last name. I hope he's white. That would just fucking blow my mind. Right, we got that. White People Wednesday. Black, white, or other. There's a topic. I got to make up some shit. And the pill mix. A lot of shit going on here. A lot of shit going on here. All right, let me pick a song. Let me pick a song. I'm going to hit him with that Peasy boy. I'm good. I'm motherfucking good. This is All Out Show, dog. Don't go nowhere.
And now, it's Sam with the news from the throat.
Well, Jude, today in the news, Spike Lee had some comments on gentrification.
Ooh. What does Spike Lee have to say about gentrification?
Well, this was at the end of a lecture at Pratt Institute for Black History Month, and he was asked a question about the other side of the gentrification debate. And his response was, let me just kill you right now, because there was some bullshit article in the New York Times saying the good of gentrification. And then he goes into a 7-minute rant, and this is just some of the highlights.
Okay, what does Spike Lee have to say about gentrification?
Here's the thing. I grew up here in Fort Greene. I grew up here in New York. It's changed. And why does it take an influx of white New Yorkers in the South Bronx, in Harlem, in Bed-Stuy, in Crown Heights, for the facilities to get better? The garbage wasn't picked up every motherfucking day when I was living in 165 Washington Park. PS20. Ooh. PS20 was Ooh. Not good. PS11. Ooh. Rothschild 294. The police weren't around. When you see white mothers pushing their babies in strollers 3 o'clock in the morning on 125th Street, that must tell you something. Then comes the motherfucking Christopher Columbus syndrome. You can't discover this. We've been here. You just can't come in Bogart. There were brothers playing motherfucking African drums in Mount Morris Park for 40 years, and now they can't do it anymore because the new inhabitants said the drums are loud. My father's a great jazz musician. He bought a house in 1968, and the motherfucking people moved in last year
and motherfucker
and called the cops on my father. He's not.
It's true.
He doesn't even play electric bass. It's acoustic. We bought the motherfucking house in 1960 motherfucking 8, and now you call the cops in 2013. Get the fuck out of here. And then he just continues, nah, you can't do that.
All right, okay, stop. Okay, all right. Okay, Spike Lee, I hear you. One, I guess you weren't doing that bad if your dad bought a fucking house, first off. So don't try to act like you're some displaced motherfucker. Two, getting mad about gentrification is like getting mad at the ocean. It's gonna happen. People migrate. That's all we've been doing for thousands and thousands and thousands of years. One community goes here, they displace another community. That community goes somewhere else. You think black people build those buildings? You weren't the first motherfuckers in that neighborhood. People fucking move. Deal with it. Just fucking deal with it. I don't like it either. But it's like, there's a lot of shit that I don't like that is just part of life. And you just gotta fucking rise above it. Or else you're gonna be sitting there bitching all the damn time. Doesn't make... Come on, Spike Lee. Every time they get a soundbite from this guy, he sounds like he's fucking whining. And the worst thing about it is, it's like, yo, I hear what you're saying. As somebody that's been kicked out of a fucking house because of that type of shit. I hear what you're saying. But you're too fucking old to be crying like that, man. And it is annoying. It's fucking annoying. When white people come to your goddamn neighborhood, and what do they do? Here's the flip side. They come to the neighborhood, right? They want to leave their suburbs because they want some culture, and they want to feel that culture because they're not happy enough with their own white culture, because their white culture is boring and bland to them. Instead of celebrating that, they go to some other culture. They're like, oh, this is so neat. Look at they're playing bongos on the street, and I can get some platanos and bacalao over here. But then once they start settling, they have that fucking family, and what do? They just want to turn it into the fucking suburbs that they left. That's all they want to do, is turn it into the suburbs that they left. Next thing you know, there's a Bed Bath & Beyond right over by your crib, and a motherfucking coffee place where you can get, like, holistic, fair trade coffee. And then they don't employ motherfuckers from that neighborhood. They employ the people that move to that neighborhood. I know it's a pain in the ass, but getting mad about it ain't gonna do shit. What else is in the news?
Also in the news, anti-gay communities are linked to shorter lives. A new study says people who are gay, lesbian, or bisexual tend to die earlier in communities where citizens are less accepting of same-sex relationships.
Wait, hold up. So motherfuckers that. Gay people who live in areas where they're less accepting tend to die earlier.
Mm-hmm. Have a shorter life expectancy. That's right.
The motherfucker's stressed out, man. Stress kills you. Mm-hmm. They probably turn to drugs.
Yep.
They live in, they get a motherfucking... They can't even enjoy a blowjob. They can't even enjoy getting their dick sucked because they're afraid someone's going to come see them. Talk shit. They can't be all flamboyant at the motherfucking grocery store. Shit is hard for them. And so they end up fucking dying. That's why if you gay, you got to go move to South, West Hollywood or some shit like that.
San Francisco.
Go over to Christopher Street and be fabulous. They'll welcome you with open arms. What else in the news?
Also in the news, PornMD has a new thing where you can actually watch live, like, what people are searching for.
So PornMD is like a...
It's one of the largest porn search engines.
Okay. Alright, so let's see. So I'm going to go there right now and I can see... It's on animalnewyork.com. That's where I can see it. Okay, let's see what people are searching for. Wild blowjob, real kill. This looks... Gianna Michelle, Little Lupe, Hard Stare. It's on a loop. I don't understand. Can you do it? I can't see it. It looks like it's just the same thing over and over again.
Hold on.
So I don't believe that. Do the porn MD. Let me see it. I want to see what people are searching for. Real time, right now.
Oh, just go to porn MD. Like,
oh.
It's pornmd.com, right?
I don't know, dude. You're the one that told me about it.
Yeah, type pornmd.com.
Okay.
And then click.
Oh, live search stream.
Yeah, live there search stream. Normal girl, wife, dildo, ride, film, anal.
My boyfriend's big cock, Dansk, Jody Moore, Chinese teen cream pie, panty packs. What the fuck is a panty packs?
I don't know.
Private geffump? What the fuck is private geffump? Gay Kid Blowjob 9. Gutter Mouth 30. Man, these cats is catching nuts. Mean Deep Throat.
Granny Compile.
Porn Villa Net India. What is it?
Granny Compile.
Granny Compile?
Well, it's Compile, like short for compilation. So I guess they want to see Granny Compilation.
Showing the Neighbors. Amateur Public Quickie. I don't like fucking in public. Indian Schoolgirl Porn. That sounds pretty good. Backroom Interview. I love that shit. I be catching mad nuts to them shits. Wild Mature Moms. Eat Come Off of Boots. Man. Yo, it's crazy how many people are, like, searching. How many? They must have a million people on there. Ladyboy P. Slime Hole. Redhead MILF. Doggy. All right, so I'm gonna tweet that so you guys can see, so you can look yourself. Chris Slater, Tired Bed, Egyptian Dance Hat Hardcore. That doesn't even sound like porn.
Yeah, some of these are weird.
Some of them are awesome.
But you could tell
every second, $3,000 is spent on the internet pornography. Someone just hit me. Supreme Truth wrote that. What was you gonna say?
I was going to say, you could tell it's real, though, because, like, a lot of this shit is, like, misspelled.
Oh, yeah. I believe that shit. I believe it. They ain't got no reason to lie. Anything else in the news? That's it? All right. That was it.
That was it for the news today.
Good job on the news today there, Sam. Coming up next. I don't know. What's coming up next?
We have Leroy Velasquez.
Oh, Leroy Velasquez to talk about carrot dating.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Let's go. Shade 45, we are back. We're doing a little interview here. We got Leroy Velasquez from Carrot Dating. It's an app where men can trade goods for the opportunity to date a girl. Is that a good way to put it, Leroy?
Absolutely. Single men can guarantee a first date with a little incentive.
Because, you know, a lot of guys, they're a little shy or something like that, or maybe they work a lot. They don't have an opportunity to go out there and get a girl. Their game's not all the way. Their little internet flirt game isn't all the way Trump tight. So they put up an ad on your web. What is it? An app? They put up an ad on your app.
What are some
of the things that they're trading for Leroy?
I mean, you have the standard gifts. You have the chocolates, the flowers. You could offer drinks. But then there's a little more unconventional. We've got spa treatments. We got a tank of gas. We have plastic surgery. I mean, there are a number of unconventional offers that you can use on Carrot Dating, depending on the type of girl you want to attract.
So, Leroy, can you tell who's going on dates? Or is this something that they agree upon offline? Is there a way to guarantee that she's going to get her shit?
Yeah, absolutely. So when you first make the offer, she could either accept, decline, or counter offer with you. Once that's accepted, you both are sent into your private page where you set up your date and exchange. And if that doesn't happen, we have a flag feature, and then we kick off members who don't follow with their end of the bargain.
Okay, so what are some of the more popular gifts that are being traded? I imagine, like, to me, I don't know if a chick would want a necklace or a ring because that's a bit intimate, but maybe like clothing or even, I don't know, exercise equipment or something like that. What do they go for?
So, interestingly enough, we did several different studies across the U.S. Using major cities and seeing how different cultures and locations affect what these women say yes to. And for example, in LA, the jewelry that you're describing, women melt to that. LA locals actually said yes to more jewelry than any other city. And in New York, it's a very high stress environment. We found that more women actually said yes to spa treatments compared to any other city. And Seattle, which is known for its coffee, obviously more women said yes to coffee dates. One of the more interesting ones we found out, though, was in Boston, the most amount of women said yes just for a free tank of gas. They went on more first dates with men if they offered a tank of gas. So it's a rather interesting social experiment. Yeah, it kind of gives you insight as to what women are really looking for.
Them bitches in Boston need some gas. You know, they got to drive and shit. I heard the traffic's bad out there.
Must so be like $4 a gallon.
You know, shit is high. Shit is high. That's like an $80 value just to go out on a date with a motherfucker. Let me ask you this. What is the, what's the income? What's the average income of the man that's, that is getting on your dating site? Do you guys ask that information?
Oh, it's much less than $100,000. This isn't a wealthy dating website. It's just the average Joe, like myself. And you can offer anything, like I said, as simple as a cup of coffee, and that could get you a first date. So we found that it's the act of giving itself that a lot of women appreciate, rather than getting stuck with some guy who will go Dutch on a tab. They know that someone's going to offer them a gift and take them out to dinner, so there really is nothing to lose.
What's that? Are the... What's the average income of the women on there? Are they, I imagine they're doing a little bit worse than the men. Is that how it is, or what?
Generally speaking, yes. It's about the same. It's roughly the same. Women outnumber the men about two to three to one. So they outnumber the men more. So,
how many success stories have you had from this? Because man, it's like I hear what you say. I would be reluctant to go on this because I think that a certain type of woman, i.e. like a gold digging ass whore, would be on this shit. And I'm not saying that women that aren't on this shit aren't gold digging ass whores, but this is definitely a place where it's like, hey, I'm gonna get some free shit to hang out with somebody.
Yeah, I could definitely see that. And it really depends on the gift itself. Personally, I wouldn't offer jewelry, like you said, on a first date, but I would definitely buy a girl a cup of coffee. I mean, you go to the bar, you buy a girl a drink just to talk to her. It's the same thing. So you just got to obviously play it smart. And you'll know,
bro,
based on how she writes her profile and, you know, your interaction, if she's worth it.
Leroy, you're going to have to be a charming, handsome motherfucker to be able to be pulling broads with some coffee off of that site. You know what I'm saying?
Hey,
like, come on, let's be real.
Yeah, and quite honestly, carrot is just that foot in the door, man. In Seattle, if more girls are saying yes to coffee, that is the foot in the door you need. And yeah, you know, not everyone is as smooth as you, dude. But I mean, it's a start, and that'll definitely help build confidence for a lot of guys who don't even get a message or even a response on a normal dating website.
Okay, so what have there been any success stories? Have you heard of anybody that's like, I don't know, engaged or anything like that, now that they've joined the site?
It's funny. We've actually received a couple emails and wedding invitations in the mail from people who've used Carrot Dating. And we've only launched in November, and there have been a couple success stories of people who met. I believe one of the offers was a shopping spree, but then another offer was just a box of chocolates. So it really depends on, I guess, the demographic, the location. But like I said, that foot in the door, man, sometimes that's the difference between happily ever after and just, you know, sitting on your ass trying to look for another girl online.
We got Leroy Velasquez here, 888-742-3345, 888-742-3345. He's talking about the Carrot Dating app. It was taken off of the Apple store for a minute there, right?
Yeah, it was deemed quote unquote objectionable, which we obviously disagree with, and we're fighting to put it back on the Apple Store.
How many users you got on there right now?
We got over 125,000 since launching in November.
Mm-hmm. All right, let's go to the phone lines. We got Denere in Detroit.
Yo, what up though? What up though?
What up though, man? You got Leroy.
Man, what up, Leroy? Hey, Leroy, I want to know, man, can I get a bitch a couple of blunts of some liquor and some churches, and I'll be able to fuck?
Hey, man, you could definitely offer a girl drinks. We do have drinks up there, so that could definitely work. And we're actually implementing open field bribes, so if you do want to offer that, you could put fill in the blank and see who says yes. But, yeah, you could offer up pretty much anything.
All right, I'm gonna check that shit out. Tell me how them hoes in Detroit look though. Is they straight or is they the rat ball muck mouse bitches or some shit? Man, like what they looking like on from Detroit?
Straight, real straight.
You ain't gonna say they ugly, man. You ain't gonna say they ugly. Y'all, I hope you get some pussy with some churches and some motherfucking henny, dog. Good luck. Yeah, what about like Leroy? I used to be real into ketamine. Can I put up like, yo, I got an 8-ball of ketamine that we can snort together? Can I put that as a little trade, or are you guys frown upon that shit? Is that where you draw the line with this prostitution?
We definitely draw the line with that. When members join, they have to sign a, they have to agree to a code of conduct. And so nothing illegal, nothing like that, no solicitation can be done. You know, just definitely not ketamine. I know for a fact you don't really want to do
bullshit.
That.
That's some bullshit. What's the wildest, what's the wildest shit you saw somebody trade for?
Plastic surgery, man. To this day, still plastic surgery is the craziest category. Seen it in Beverly Hills, and someone actually did it, got a date. I guess he was a surgeon, but yeah. Isn't that nuts? Someone you don't even know.
I hope
know
he got
either.
Some pussy. I hope he got some motherfucking pussy for that. I'm sure he did. If a bitch is willing to do that, she probably will give up that motherfucking ass. Let's go to Mark in Ware, Massachusetts. Mark, go ahead.
Oh, how you doing? Obviously, you already answered that question. I just wanted to know, what was the highest a person spent on a person? What, on this website,
like what's the highest? Is plastic surgery the highest price thing someone did on this website, or is there something even higher that they traded for?
Yeah, obviously it depends on the surgery, but I'd say that was probably the highest thing spent. There's a lot of expensive things too. You could offer like there's skydiving. I mean, there's concert tickets. So say you want to go to a really popular concert, that could be expensive as well. It really depends on the situation, but I'd say across the board, yeah. What's up?
Could I offer to, like, eat her asshole on the first date as a trade? Like, look, if you come out with me on a date, I will eat your asshole, regardless.
Yeah, that's something you have to, too, we'll have to discuss privately. If she's into that.
So I can't even, I can't carrot date analingus? I don't
know
about the site for me.
we'll look into analingus. It's not a category right now, but...
Okay. All right, let's go to Joe P. in the D. Go ahead, Joe P.
Hey, Rude Jude. You're the best, man. Hey, I want to know. I'm out here in Detroit, and girls are fucking for the 20. So if I get on this site, is there some kind of hierarchy here, like a cup of coffee for the dome, full tank of gas to get in the ass? Oh, I'm just curious there. Are they advertising different prices for different shit?
No, there is no price. It really is the gift itself. So say you offer 10 girls a cup of coffee, and one of them says yes, that's the foot in the door you need. And honestly, there is no, every girl's different. You know, some girls, maybe they're running low on E and they're a straight dime. I mean, they could say yes to that. So there's just so much potential. You might as well just send out an offer and it's free. So
Mike in Houston, go ahead, Mike. You're the last one.
Hey man, I got a quick question. I heard you ask if there are success stories. I was wondering if he's a success story, if he found his old lady online.
Me?
Did you get your girl off of carrot dating?
I went on a couple dates carrot dating, and I've tried both the shopping spree, which obviously helped, but then I've also tried flowers, and I got a girl to say yes, and I actually went on a couple more dates with her. So it works, and I wouldn't talk about this product if I didn't experience it myself, because it is a rather modern concept, but man, it works. Get that foot.
You still with her?
Are you still with her, or did you go your separate ways?
Well, my separate ways. I, you know, want to focus on my career, stay single. You know,
okay. She dumped you, son. You want to focus on your career. Yo, Leroy, which one was cooler, the chick that hung out with you for the shopping spree or the chick that hung out with you for the flowers?
Ooh, good question. I mean, they were both cool because I went on more dates with both of them, but... The one with the actual flowers was actually the one I went on a couple more dates with because, like you said earlier, in the back of my head, I thought maybe she's just using me for my money. But this girl, all I gave her was a flower, and then she was still interested past the first date. So
there it is. All right, Leroy, I want to thank you. Why don't you let everybody know where to get your app from?
Yeah, so it's www.carrotdating.com. We're available in the Android store. And, try it for yourself. Over 125,000 members worldwide, and first date's a bribe away.
There it is. It's, yo, it's, it's kind of, you guys are kind of being honest about shit, because let's be real, like half these chicks on here are, you know, they're reading between the lines anyway. They're looking at dude's pictures, seeing what kind of car he's in front of, what kind of shit how he's dressed. You know, there's some like low key gold digging ass broads anyway. So let's call a spade, go run over to Carrot Dayton, you know, trade a first date for a juicer, and maybe you can meet somebody nice. All right, man, that's Leroy Velasquez, Carrot Dayton. We're going to play some music and come on back. Yes, indeed, we're an hour into this awesome show, the All Out Show. Hope you like it so far. We have the Carrot Dayton guy on there. You can learn about how to pull a broad with a toaster. How to use a juicing or a blender to get a date. Just go to Carrot Dating and trade. Trade goods for a little time. You also learn that if you're a gay person, you should probably go to a gay-friendly neighborhood or else you're going to die early. Imagine from like stress-related shit, drinking too much, eating too much. Getting too much AIDS. Sometimes I just say jokes for me. They're just for me. They're my little jokes that tickle me. So we have for the rest of the show, we're doing White People Wednesday. We're doing Black, White, or Other. This is all good stuff. There's a Pill Mix rerun. Is there anything else? We'll give away some shit. We'll give away some shit for the Black, White, or Other. You should follow us at All Out Show. Also, hey, people been bothering Jude or McDude, they've been bothering me about them pill mixes. Jude, how come you don't post a pill mix? How come you don't post a pill mix? Guess what? You can now go to SoundCloud and get my pill mixes. I don't even know if I'm allowed to do it. They'll probably shut me down. But like, while it's up, go to Rude Jude 1 and you can get pill mixes. You can listen to pill mixes. You're welcome until they shut me down. You should follow me on Instagram too. Like, for instance, we're doing White People Wednesday on Instagram right now with some really funny pictures. I got one with this guy where his dick is an arm flexing. Go to One More Jude, at One More Jude on Instagram. Also, you can follow me on Twitter, at @Rude_Jude, for White People Wednesday tweets and me plugging my book shamelessly over and over again. Speaking of which, have you bought my book yet? It's Hyena. It's on Amazon. Oh, you haven't? Why? Because you don't read books? You're too hard to read a book, or you're too poor to afford $10? Well, I got news for you, buddy. Save up. Go on Amazon and get that motherfucking Hyena. Because it's the realest shit I ever wrote. I pocked that shit. That was this Hyena was my Me Against the World. You think I'm bullshitting? It was my Me Against the World. But like, instead of like being locked up, I'm just cracking jokes and shit. Talking about doing drugs and fucking broads. I think you'll like it. Chicks really dig it. You chicks should really dig it. Is there anything else I need? Oh, All Out Show, Sirius XM On Demand if you want to listen to the best ofs. And then best of the week, Sunday nights, 10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. All right, don't go nowhere. Oh, John in Oklahoma wants to shout me out. What's up, John in Oklahoma? Go ahead, shout me out, bro.
What's up, man? What up, Rude? You know, I follow you on Twitter, man, and, you know, and I was looking at your White People Wednesday picks and everything. But I just want to say, man, I really appreciate you, you know, like, as I'm getting into my adult ages, you know, I'm 26. I like how you, you know, satire us with your good, you know, humor. You know what I'm saying? Because it makes me feel like I'm listening to some real good hip-hop radio with, like, a suit on. Even though I got no suit on, I got, like, sweats, but...
Yeah. That's what it's all about. Like, yeah, I want everybody to be suited and booted in their brain, man. I'm going to suit them and boot them in the brain. Let's play some music. Come on back. Oh, man, fuck that, man. What's up, y'all? Oh, shit. You got some stones going on in the background? How you doing out there? I want you to look at the calendar. You see it? What day does it say? It says Wednesday. That's right. And you hear some guitar music in the background, right? Now, if you're a regular listener, you can use your powers of deduction and figure out that we're about to do a little something called White People Wednesday. Now, what's White People Wednesday? Is that racist? No, it's not racist. It's enlightened. We're here to enlighten you about Caucasians. Now, I know a lot of y'all cats don't have white friends. Maybe you're not friendly enough with your white friends where you can ask them the fucking curious, the things that you're curious about white people. Well, I suggest you pick up the phone right now. Dial 888-742-3345. 888-742-3345. And call us up with your white people questions for White People Wednesday. Can't get through on the phone? Hit me up on an email. All Out Show 45 with your White People Wednesday questions. Oh, wait. It's at Gmail. All Out Show 45 at Gmail with your White People Wednesday questions. You're not into email? Well, fucking hey. Hit me up on Twitter at @Rude_Jude. There's so many ways to get to me with your white people questions. Well, why should I ask you, Jude? What the fuck do you know about white people? I know everything about white people. I've been white for motherfucking 37 years. 36 years. What have you been doing for 36 years? I've been being white. So I feel like I know a thing or two about Caucasians. Pick up the phone. Dial 888-742-3345. 888-742-3345. And talk to the Caucasian liaison. I'm your conduit. I'm going to bring you to white people. I'm going to help you jump inside of the white brain. I'm not saying it's right. I'm not saying it's wrong. I'm just saying it is. What's good? Pedro here. This is an email I'm reading. Pedro here. Why do white people carry their 7-year-old son or daughter around the stores like they're newborns and talk to their asses like babies? Pedro, based on your name, I'm going to guess that you're some type of Hispanic. Here's the deal. We don't have as many kids as you. Therefore, we value them more. Our kids are like limited edition fucking Nike Jordans. Your kids are like the Nikes that they sell at Payless. Like there's a gang of them motherfuckers. That's what, you don't baby them. We baby our fucking kids because they're very valuable. If we break our child, we don't have another one. We only have like one or two kids and a dog. That's it. So, yeah, okay, to the outsider, it looks like we're overvaluing them. And maybe we are. Maybe we are. But it's only because they're very rare. The white child is a very, very rare thing. You're not seeing big families. And these motherfucking moms, they don't start having kids till what? They get out of college, they got their career going, and boom, they're like 37 years old with a 2-year-old. They're a fucking cunt hair away from menopause, bro. They can't afford to lose that child. That's why they carry it around like it's so precious. And then when you carrying something around like it's so precious, you can't help but talk to it like this. Isn't that right, Hunter? Isn't that right, my widow Hunter? Yes, you are. And where's Poppy? And where's Poppy? And where's Ivy? And where's Olivia? And we also like to name our kids off after like dead old people, like Olivia, Poppy, Esther, Ivy, shit like that. Cause it's fun. How come when a bartender at a bar puts out pretzels, why do white people get all excited and tear them pretzels up? It's a good question. Cause pretzels go awesome with beer and whiskey, and that's what the fuck we drink. They don't go very well with Hennessy. That's what the fuck you drink. You know what goes good with Hennessy? French shit, because it's a French drink. Pretzels is all American, all American. Well, actually, it's German. Beer's somewhat German. I don't know what the fuck I'm talking about right now. Look, pretzels are delicious, okay? Pretzels are fucking delicious, and that's why we love them shits. Same reason why we love mayonnaise, because it's delicious. Same reason why we like mayonnaise-based salads, because they're delicious. What else are we supposed to eat? fucking Flamin' Hot Cheetos? I don't think so. That doesn't go well with Jack Daniels, sir. Why do white people think diapers is part of a wardrobe for babies and no shoes for babies? Last time I checked, babies aren't running a fucking marathon or going to work. What do you want us to put our baby in? A tuxedo? A three-piece suit? Some John Varvatos? It's a fucking baby. It shits on itself every 2 hours. We're not wasting all our money on fucking baby clothes like that. Especially if it's summertime out. And guess what? Babies can get away with that. Shit, I let a kid walk around butt naked. I don't give a fuck. And if you stare at her genitals, I'm gonna call you goddamn pervert. We are not ashamed of the human body. We embrace it. We embrace it. 888-742-3345. It's White People Wednesday. Hey, I'm gonna hit you with a little bit of this. 888-742-3345. 888-742-3345. It is White People Wednesday. Yo, you got a Caucasian question? Hit me up at @Rude_Jude on Twitter, or you can shoot an email over to alloutshow45@gmail.com. Can you hear me forgetting that every fucking time? Every time I have to say it, I can't remember it. Call me up right now. 888-742-3345. Eastside Frank, what is your question?
Hey, Jude, what up, what up, what it do, my boy? Hey, I'm glad that I got through, you know what I'm saying? Because, you know, I've been following you for a minute. But here's my question for White People Wednesday, you know what I'm saying? Hey, why do white people love eating roast beef? Y'all motherfuckers defy that shit, you know what I'm saying? I mean it. Like, I ain't trying to clown and all that, you know what I'm saying? Y'all motherfuckers is love eating that shit, you know what I'm saying? That's my question. Eastside Frank from South Central, hit me up.
That's Eastside Frank out there in South Central. Here's why white people love roast beef. Because we can afford that shit. One, two, we also like white sauces. And anything we can put a white sauce on, i.e. mayonnaise and horseradish at the same damn time, we're going to do it. It's kind of weird, but like we like our food to look like it's been smothered in cum. I know it's crazy. Also the other thing about roast beef is That shit actually tastes pretty good. Have you had some good ass roast beef? Like, go over to, there's a spot over on La Brea and Pico. Go get you some roast beef. I swear to God, bam, I swear by it. Shout out to Top Round over. Look at me pluck. See, that's how much I like roast beef. Even as a vegetarian, I worked at Arby's slanging motherfucking roast beef. We got Castro in Miami.
Yo, what's good, man? How y'all doing this afternoon?
What up, though?
Yeah, man, I'm just trying to figure out, man, why white people are always taking over the badass kid in the neighborhood, man. Like, well, let's bring him home for dinner and try to straighten them out. Like, what's up with that, man?
Because, man, we are thinking ahead. All right, look, here's the deal. We see a badass kid in the neighborhood. We're not thinking about the badass kid. Well, some of them are. There's a little bit of white guilt in there that wants to save the world. But also, we're a pragmatic group of people. And if I look out for this kid and try to get him on the right path, that means he's not going to break out my car window and steal my shit 5 years from now. You see what I'm saying? We're just trying to make shit better for us. I'm helping out that nice kid so he doesn't break into my home in 10 years looking for some money so he could buy some meth. We got Melissa in Indiana. What's up?
Hey, Jim. What's going on?
Chilling. What is your question?
I am curious as to why white women are always looking at the ends of their hair and then flipping it.
Why do white women always look at the ends of our hair, their hair? Because here's the deal. As Caucasians, one of the bad things about being white is you get sunburned and chapped lips. And did I mention sunburn? That sucks too. But with that good ass hair that we have, our hair is a little bit more delicate, and we tend to get split ends. So they're checking to see if their shit's tidy right or not. And then if it's not, we go to the salon and cut that shit. Yeah, we get split ends mad easy. Here it is. Chris in Houston, what's your question?
Jude, what is up?
What's happening, man?
Not much. I'm a Caucasian myself, and I still don't understand the answer to this question. Maybe you can help me out. Why do white people love Sunday brunch so much? I don't get that shit.
Why do white people love brunch so much? Because it's another reason to go out there and trick off some cash. It's a status symbol, my man. And what says that you're doing better than going, being able to go to a fucking restaurant and drop fucking $15 on some goddamn eggs that cost what? 25 cents?
Probably. My sister, so. I just don't understand it.
Dude, Chris, I don't like it either. Like, I don't like shit about the brunch. But, and that's the thing. It's like, here's the deal. I don't like brunch, but if I want to hang out with my white friends, I have to go to fucking brunch. My sister took me there like last week. I ended up getting a $5 cup of coffee that tasted pretty delicious. It had berry undertones. It was very aromatic. I got one egg with in a skillet with some fingerling potatoes, and it cost me damn near $20.
I just don't get that.
Yeah, look,
I
man,
don't.
It's like
my friends do the same thing. They're like, "Why don't you go to brunch?"
Dude, everybody has that. Everybody has their own little shit. You know what I mean? Some people put rims on their car. We just go to brunch. That's how we show that we're stunting. That's how we show that we're in stunt mode. Sarah in Milwaukee.
So my question is, why do white people love to eat black girls' pussy?
Why do white people love to eat black girls' pussy? You're kind of right and you're wrong at the same time. Don't think that you're special. You know what I mean? Don't think that we're just like fiending to eat black pussy. We just love to eat fucking pussy. Okay? We just love to eat pussy, and it happens to be that you're black, so you're going to get your fucking pussy ate.
Even the white girls love to eat it too.
I'm just going to hang up on you because fuck you. Even the white girls love to eat it too. Do they? Is that the consensus? White girls are just fucking fiending to eat fucking black pussy. I know a lot of white girls and that never comes up in conversation. Like, gee, I wonder what I could eat today. Some black pussy. Nah, I don't think so. Justin in North Carolina.
Yo, what's up, man? How you doing, bro?
Chilling, man. What is your question?
Yo, man, why do white people talk so proper, bro? Like, switch it up a little bit, man. Throw some swag in there, you know what I'm saying? Like, what the fuck?
Swag equals broke, my friend, okay?
Not really, not all the time, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, really. Like, if you're my fucking doctor and you come into the office and try to swag it out on me, guess what the fuck I'm going to do? I'm going to walk it out. You're not going to, you just lost some dough.
Man,
fuck swag. Swag's for McDonald's.
Bro.
Swag is for McDonald's. You want, look, if you're a rapper, swag it the fuck out. If you're not a goddamn rapper or work as a DJ, you better get your proper speak on. You better get your proper word talking on, because I'm not going to trust you. If I go to a lawyer and he tries to swag it out on me, I'm fucking walking out of the office. I'll have all the swagger. Thank you very much. Why don't white people talk like that? Come on, man. All right, we're going to do one more round of this. 888-742-3345. 888-742-3345. Hold on, I'm going to hit him with a cork. Hey, man, hit him with that vanilla ice. Ice, ice, baby. Hit him with that motherfucking vanilla. Like that song. 888-742-3345. It's White People Wednesday. We do an extended version since I'm the white boy here by myself. You got a question about white people, call up right now. I will answer that question. Why? Because, you know, in case you don't have any white friends, I'll keep it real with you, man. I'm going to keep it all the way real. We got Jeff in Miami. What is your question?
Hey, man. Why do white people always show up to work on time, punch in on time? punch your ass in and fuck around, then do the work. Hey, man, we got fucking work to do, dude. Let's go.
Why do white people show up to work on time and work?
I mean, look at Spears. Spears, like, he gets the job done.
Yeah, I hear you. Yeah, I know.
Even though he got one sandwich in one hand.
Does he get the job done, though? Really? Does he? Like, come on. Let's be all the way honest about this shit. Here's the deal, and here's the secret. Like, with white people, 5 minutes early is 10 minutes late. You see what I'm saying? 5 minutes early is 10 minutes late. You get there on time, right? You get there on time. You punch in. You make sure the boss sees you. Then you fuck off a little bit. Everybody else is doing it wrong. Everybody else is doing it wrong. Hey, and if I do stay late, I make sure the boss sees me. Because if the boss doesn't see me, then it's like it never fucking happened. We're just trying to get cool points with the boss so that we can be the boss one of these days. That's it, man. And guess who's not going to be the boss? Fucking Johnny not on time. Mr. Don't show up to work. Mr. Excuses. We show up on time for work because we got a fucking wife that is nagging us. We got child support. Try it out. I'm telling you. Try that shit out. Skrill's in New York.
Hey, what up, Jude?
What's up?
Hey, man, I want to know why the fuck white motherfuckers stay getting caught fucking horses and cows and shit, man.
Why do white people get caught fucking horses and cows? Maybe because horse pussy's good. I don't know.
Hey, but that shit nasty as fuck. I stay seeing that shit in the news, man. Some white motherfucker got caught molesting some motherfucking cows or something.
I heard about it. I heard about it because we're a disgusting people. And I kind of, you know what? I'm going to be all the way real with you. The more disgusting we are, the more I like us white people. When I see us starting to get a little bit more buttoned down and pussified, that's when I think we're losing our edge. Like, I would rather have a guy, I'd rather have a dude fucking a horse than being on a gluten-free diet. Because then it's like, all right, this dude is grimy and disgusting. Just like an old barbarian or some shit. This dude can't eat bread like a fucking pussy. Who do I pick? The horse fucker every time. Tink in Baltimore. Tink, what up? What is your question?
Hey, dude, what's going on, man? Yo.
What's
up? I want to know, why do white people be picking their nose when they driving? There's a second part to that. Do they pick their nose at home? And then the third part is, what the fuck do they do with that boogie?
Here's the first part. We don't carry around toilet tissue because we have money in our pockets instead. We don't have room for that shit. And credit cards. A lot of us carry credit cards. Secondly, our having thinner nostrils, shit gets stuck in there a little bit more often. And I do pick my nose when I drive. And the reason why I do it, because I don't give a fuck. I'm disgusting. I'm gross. I'm a gross individual. I will pick my fucking nose. And this is what we do with it. We roll it on our finger and flick it out the fucking window. Like a goddamn disgusting motherfucker that we are. Just because we're fucking gross, dude. That's why we do it.
But dude.
What's that?
We might do it too. We might do it too while we driving. But if somebody pull up on the side, we stop. White folks don't stop. They just keep on going to the next knuckle.
The thing is you gotta do the slick way, like you're scratching your nose with your pointer finger, but you got the thumb up in there and you're trying to get it on out. It's good. I'm glad to know that everybody picks their nose, Tink, because I thought it was just us.
Yeah, but we try to hide it. White folks don't give a shit. They just say fuck it.
This is true. Let's go to Suzette and Charlotte. Suzette, what's up?
Hey, Jude.
How you doing?
I need to know why white people don't close their blinds or put curtains up. You can see straight through their house, everything they have, everything they're doing. Why do they do that?
Because we live in good neighborhoods and don't have to worry about our own neighbors breaking into our shit.
Okay. People can talk through your neighborhood, man.
Yeah, that's why when minorities drive through white neighborhoods, they get pulled over and fucked with, so that white people can continue leaving their shit open. Poof. There you go. There you go. Bye bye. All right, we're done. We are done with White People Wednesday. See, I don't even knock these hoes. Mississippi, stand up. Shape 45. You want to play a game? You want to play a little game with us? Got this shit called Black, White, or Other. Got 5 headlines in the news. I'll read you the headline. And then you gotta guess whether the person is black, white, or other based on the shit that they're doing. Pretty straightforward. Other would be like Hispanic, Asian, Arab, African. Shit like that. Jamaican. Jamaican's black. Is it really black? I mean, they're black, but you know. It's a whole different culture. Damn, look at them phone lines blow up. People love this fucking game. I don't blame you. It's a fun game. You can also win a G-Pen. And I'll throw in a copy of my book. What's the book about? It's about my fucking life, okay? And it's good. Like, it's kind of awesome. I don't even mean to toot my own horn, but the shit is awesome. So, if you don't feel like dropping 10 bucks on my book, Hyena, you'll win a book. And today I'm feeling a little generous, so you just got to get 3 out of 5 right. You get 3 out of 5 right, you win a book and a G-Pen. It's a killer combination. Or if you're not into getting high, we'll throw you a dildo or a fuck egg. Shout out to lubezilla.com and Tinga for the fuck eggs. You still a little confused? Sam's going to do an example for us. Go ahead.
A security chief is...
Turn up yourself. I can't hear you. Go ahead. Turn up your mic. Thank you.
A security chief is charged with masturbating into a woman's shoe.
A security chief is charged with masturbating into a woman's shoe.
Mm-hmm.
I'm thinking of China when I hear this because, like, there's a couple reasons. Like, security chief sounds like some Chinese shit. Like, we got, like, I don't know. What the fuck is a security chief? Heard of, like, lieutenants and shit like that and captains. And then chiefs are in, like, the Navy or some shit like that, maybe. But fucking security chief, that sounds like some Chinese policeman. And the fact that he's jerking off into a shoe, I'm saying it's some Asian shit. But everybody's got a foot fetish. Actually, mostly white guys got foot fetishes. All right, I'm sticking with Chinese. I'm sticking with Asian. Is it Asian?
It wasn't Asian. It was white. You should have just went with the foot fetish thing.
We do love feet, but that really threw me off with that fucking security chief. What the fuck is a security chief?
He's like public safety type deal.
Oh, word.
Yeah.
Word. Okay. All right. All right. So that's how you play the game. I got it wrong, but it doesn't matter because I'm not playing for shit. I already own my book, Hyena, on Amazon. Go buy it for real. Don't be a dick. And I don't smoke weed, so I don't need a G-Pen. And I already own a fuck egg. So if you want to win some shit, call up right now. 888-742-3345. It's Black, White, or Other. It's coming up next.
In an attempt to quell racial stereotypes, the All Out Show presents Black, White, or Other on Shade 45.
All right, it's Shade 45, Black, White, or Other. We're playing for the chance to win a G-Pen or a dildo or a fuck egg and the book I wrote called Hyena. Okay, James in Texas.
Yep, what's up, man? What's
what are you playing for?
I'm trying to go for that G-Pen.
Okay, all right, so you're playing for the G-Pen.
Yeah.
And you get a book, too. So you got it. You just got a lot at stake right here, sir. There's a lot at stake. You ready to play this shit?
I'm ready to do it.
All right, James here has got to get 3 out of 5 questions right. I'm going to read a headline to him. He's got to say whether the person is black, white, or other. 3 out of 5, and you win.
Yep,
okay.
Yep.
A man steals a sound system only to come back for the remote.
All right. Let me see here. Stereo equipment, bass, person breaking into a car. That sounds straight niggerish right there. I'm gonna let you know that right now. And then to come back and get the remote control, because he forgot that shit, yeah, I'm gonna go with black on that one.
I'm gonna give you a name. You tell me if I'm gonna give you a name. You tell me if you think you're right or wrong.
Okay.
Carlos Ruiz.
Oh shit. Damn.
Yeah. Y'all ain't the only ones that like bass. All right, here's the next one. Woman tells waitress to give her a free meal or she will go to hell.
Okay. What kind of meal was it? You know, I can see if it was like some fried chicken or something. I know that is. You know, some egg rolls.
Here's the deal. Here's what I can tell you. She ordered $18.46 worth of food. Gave the cashier two options, either give her a free meal and go to heaven, or charge the credit card and go straight to hell.
Charge the credit card, go straight to hell. Mm-hmm. I've been in that situation before, you know, where I cross my fingers and hope that damn credit card go through. So I'm going to go with black on this one, too.
Is it black?
It is.
Congratulations. You got one right, you got one wrong. Okay, a woman leaves child in the father's mailbox.
Wow. Wow. Did it have a bill attached to it or something? Damn. That's
crucial. Yeah. Yeah, she, I don't even know if the guy was a father. She just believed that he was a father. She put the baby in the mailbox, came back, dropped off two baby bags, left again, and then got into an accident and tried to jump off a bridge.
Damn. That sounds like some... Damn. I mean, just the story alone is just sick, but you know what? Baby being left in the mailbox.
I need an answer. Come on, man.
I'm gonna go with white.
Is it white? Oh.
Damn.
Sorry. Yes. Robber yielding a meat cleaver tries to rob a bank. Teller laughs at him.
A meat cleaver. You know, it sounds like, you know, some old other shit, you know. Blacks use a gun. Whites use masks. Disguised as black. So I'm going to go with other on this one.
Is it other? All right. You got two right, you got two wrong. This is for all the marbles. This is for the G-Pen. This is for the book Hyena. And here it goes. Woman leaves baby on top of her car and drives off.
You know, I've left some stuff on top of my car before. You know, coffee, sandwich, but not no damn baby. White people forgetful about their kids sometimes, so I think I'm going to go with white.
For the G-Pen and Hyena, is it white? Congratulations.
Bet on.
Clap it up.
That's what I'm talking
Clap
about,
it
baby.
Up.
Yeah.
You won. All right, James in Texas. Congratulations. You won black, white, or other. Thanks for playing. Enjoy the G-Pen. Enjoy the book. And we'll get that out to you soon. All right, dog?
Yo, Beck, can you sign it for me, dog?
I cannot sign it because it's being sent from from New York.
Okay.
I'm not in New York. Yo, Sam, is there any signed books?
No.
Weren't.
It's all good. I catch you at South by Southwest.
Yeah, please do. Please do. Yep. I'll sign it for you there. All right, then.
All right.
Peace. All right, there it is. That was Black, White, or Other. Do you think you have what it takes to win a Black, White, or Other? Well, tune in next week and try to play. Coming up next, it's going to be, what do we got next? What is next?
Pillmix.
Pillmix is next. Don't go nowhere, y'all. Pillmix is coming up next. Find me in the club. What's up, y'all? All right, so it's all out, y'all. And we're almost done. I know, it's like, we're almost done? Well, we got a mix coming up. It's going to be a best of mix. Sam, how's it start? Let me hear what we got lined up here.
It's still
what
loading.
What do we got lined up for them?
It's loading over here.
Oh, it's still loading?
Yeah.
Okay.
It will be done in 2 minutes.
Just in 2 minutes. You guys just wait 2 minutes and I will play you that fucking, some of that mix that I was going to preview right now. That's fucking awesome.
I know you hate me.
Right now, I just fucking hate you. This is what we have for tomorrow. We got Bunny Wailer for Bob Marley and the Wailers, the bass line dude, the dude that did all the awesome bass lines. He's going to come in for Throwback Thursday, and we're going to do all the Bob Marley joints. Well, not all of them because there's so many, but all the Bob Marley and the Wailer joints. Here, let me pull up his. Maybe he did this. Well, this is that's a live version. Hold on one second. Not that that's not cool. What about this? He did. He did this. We could talk about this. Lines were always dope. He always had some thumpers. So we'll talk to him about that. And he said he was responsible for a lot of those grooves. Boom. So that sound that you like so much, Bunny was responsible for that sound. And that's tomorrow. So make sure you tune in tomorrow. Also, I'll be doing a live pill mix. So that's two pill mixes in a row. Bam, you're welcome. You are fucking welcome. Pretty neat. Is there anything else worth talking about?
Seerverse Words tomorrow.
Seerverse Words. Seerverse Words. We got a special edition for tomorrow. I'm curious to see how he's going to do. It's a surprise edition, and we'll tell you all about it tomorrow. And then I think that's it. You know, just the other shit, ghetto music news and us being awesome. And us being awesome. So, oh yeah. And if you miss any of the show, you can always listen to us on demand. Go to Sirius.com on demand. The best of is Sunday nights at 10 p.m. Eastern. You can follow us at All Out Show on Twitter and on Instagram. Or you can follow me on Instagram at One More Jude. I'm on Twitter at @Rude_Jude. And I wrote a book called Hyena. And you can buy that on Amazon if you feel like it. All right.
The mix is loaded.
Look at that. I burnt 2 minutes. Look at me burning fucking 2 minutes.
I know.
Let me hear. How are we going to start? How are we going to start that shit? Oh, this is old school shit. This is a... What's the name of this group? I think they use this song in that one Tom Cruise movie where he gets in the car accident or falls off some shit and his face gets all fucked up. It's in Vanilla Sky. Spiritualized. I start with Spiritualized. Who else is starting with Spiritualized? Just me. Rude_Jude. Hit me. Rude_Jude. Get at me. I'll shout you out. Baby Chino, what up? Scissor Hands, what up? Chris Biv, smoked out, shy yo money, Felix, what up though, Tooth Taker, Ross Downwind, Big Eve, the Far East Man, I don't take requests, Jay Marshall, motherfucking Jones. Fuscat, what up? BMW King.
Tequila.
Redbeard Jew. Mike Saint. I drive trucks, professional asshole. G-Code 78. Texans run the South. Rob Nathaniel. Big Debo, Jay Nasty, DJ Stan the Man.
Tequila!
Now let's get this shit motherfucking gone. 888-742-3345. I got time for a couple calls. Be quick, in and out, y'all. In and out, y'all. Quickity quick. Quickie quickie. Quickie quickie. Oh shit, hold up. Oh shit, hold up. Oh shit, hold up.
say I love you? Need I say I care? Need I say that emotions something we don't share?
Let's go to Anthony in North Carolina. Yo, Ant, what up?
That much, man. I love the show. The Field Mix is a damn Thursday throwdown. Love that shit in North Carolina, man. We love that.
Thank you, dog. I appreciate you, man. That's out there in North Kakalaki doing that shit. Ed in North Dakota.
What's up, big dog?
What up, though?
What's up, dog? How you doing, man? Hey, I got a question for you, man. What you
go ahead.
Live, man. Do you think the game would be the way it is right now?
As you know, I know, baby, that I don't want to go.
I don't speculate on dead rappers. Danny Boy.
Yo, what up, son?
What up, though, man?
Hey, yo, fuck AM, fuck FM, fuck all that bullshit on the radio, boy. It's all about that Field Mix, man. I'm still waiting on that Field Mix Pandora station, goddammit.
I know, right? I should get a Field Mix Pandora station.
Patting that shit. That's a moneymaker right there, man. Keep doing what you're doing, bro. All right,
now. Red in Texas.
Hey, what's up, you know, Kevin Hart?
What up, though, man?
Tell Kevin Hart he's funny than a motherfucker.
I can't even hear what you're saying, but that's awesome, man. Ooh, woo, woo. I'm going to sing to you. Scooby-Doo. Fuck you. Todd in Vancouver. What up, man?
Yo, Jude, you know how we do.
How do we do?
Smoking that super fucking Kale Kush. Just right. Smoke some butter. Two wings to fly. You know how we do.
That's how you do. All right. Shout out to how you do. Rick in New Mexico.
Yo, what's up, Jude?
What up, though, man?
Making that A-Rap money over here in the oil fields in New Mexico, brother. Just want to say what's up. We listen to your show every day, doggy.
That's cool, man. Thank you, dog. We try to hold it down for all y'all cats out there in the oil fields. Everybody trucking. Cats making them trips across the straight line and shit. We got you. Prodigy, what up, man? Yo, Prodigy.
Yo.
What up, though, man?
What's going on, homie?
Man, you got it.
Shout out to the 814, PA okay. Stand Up. Much respect to the West Coast, though. Anybody know where King T at?
Nah, it's a good question. He's probably out there making money somewhere, man. Jay in Philly.
Yo, what up, Jew? What's going on, baby? I listen to y'all every day, man, from the start of work to the time I get home. Yo, you funny as shit, man.
Thank you, dog.
Shout out to the 215, baby. Andrew, Jude, Lord, Sarah, and motherfucking Sway in there. Y'all be holding it down, dog.
All right. Thank you, man. Vince in Pennsylvania. Go ahead, Vince.
Yo, Jude, what up?
What's happening, man?
Yo, you put me on the Doughboy Cash Out. You're the man for that.
I'm glad you dug that.
Awesome.
Doughboy's yeah, Cash Out
my
shit.
Dresser, what's up?
My chain shit. On my dresser. Thank God the bag came. All that shit. Shout out to Payroll. Look at that, man. We got it in, got it out. I'm the fuck done. Phil Collins in the mix. Shit, I'm good, man. I'm fucking good. Coming up next is Show Off Radio. Shout out to motherfucking Sam handling the shit. She's working double duties. Also Denise on them phones. Sarah's a co-host. My name is Jude Anthony Angelini. Thank you to the lady that wrote that book, Don't Let the White Girl Win, about fucking black dudes if you're a black chick, and Who Kid for sitting in with us for about an hour and a half. He's always funny. I'm the fuck out of here. Pill Mix is out. I'm talking about putting